advocate order to the light of consciousness.
It's a nice Well, what I want to present to you is a point a little bit out of the line, because I want to present to you is the point of view from the therapeutic view. Well, my name is Finassi, I'm from Brazil. I'm a therapist, researcher, writer, and president of ABC Systems. It's the Brazilian Association of Systemic Constellator. Constellation is a psychotherapy very specific. Well, from bones, Holness and Weizsäcker and Gornitz troposes, proliposes, to Firassi and Amaral troposes. We go to see from proliposes to through troposes. The way of holiness and integrated order to the light and consciousness. Okay. But life unfolding matter, light and consciousness by proliposes. And the state of observation in which troposes is disclosed for the deepest possible change in the therapeutic encounter. I was a student of Professor David Bohm. By the time he had already published the Holiness in Implicated Order. In that time we was together, you know, he lives in Brazil from 50 to 55, so many times we speak in Portuguese, and he, Sarah, invited me to his wife to dinner. In a certain moment he says that physics, as we know, don't belong to the physicists, but belongs to the therapists. In that time he started doing the own dialogue seminars. In 10 years later, I became a therapist. Here is the time. Okay. In 2013, I met Professor Thomas Gorlitz, quantum physicist in Acapulco, Mexico. Getting to know his and Weizsäcker's concepts of proliposes. You know, Carl Friedrich von Weizsäcker is a quantum physicist and philosopher. Well, these three persons are the pillar of this investigation. So I bring this question to warm up the presentation. What is involved in therapeutic approach? What is the mystery of therapeutic gaze? This is different from scientific one. What happens in therapeutic encounter? What is therapy? In which way observation does change the light of consciousness to the client? In at least, what is observation? This is not a thesis to be demonstrated, it's to be taken like an inspiration to be tested. It's an invitation to nourish, and our curiosity invites us to a deep, to dive in this deep. Well, Bert Hellinger is German, one lived 19 years. He founded the family constellation system. He points some interesting points that I show you. The therapist has no purpose. He does not want to cure the patient. It's different of someone who wants to take some results. The therapist just floats the movement. Doesn't matter to what end result. He is not afraid of the outcome. The therapist does not look for the problem. He looks at the solution. Obviously, unknown. The work is conducted by a special energy but not a personal energy. In this review, we can see that therapy is a change in consciousness, but is a change from a state of less liberty and freedom to be and express oneself to a state of being closer to what oneself really is. According to quantum physics, changes are always quantum leaps, not a smooth process. It means discontinuity. In order to understand what we have to understand with bone, bicycle, and organs, matter, energy, and meaning are the basis of the universe and how they come about. Or, pointed by a lecture of David Bohm, we are together and one of the colleagues asked him, Professor, which letters you write down the word God? And he said, the word God, matter, energy, and meaning. In that moment, I understand inside myself what it is, the alpha, beta, gamma. But I will tell you later about that. Bohm tells us that the universe manifests itself from a state of apparent no-being, which he calls implicated order, to a state of manifestation called explicate order. From nothing to something, a wholeness, an infinite potential that unfolds itself in totality of objects, as we know the universe. Weizsäcker and Gordon say that something or physics are more than an extension of logics, and physics information differ from destination or meaning of knowledge, so meaning always has a subjective aspect too. Meaning cannot be used by a basis for science and objectivity. In quantum information is the best base for understanding matter and energy. It must be conceived in absolute quantum information, free of meaning. So, it is denominated as protoposis, the name that Thomas Gordon and Weizsäcker found. Protoposis enables a fundamentally new understanding of matter, which can be seen as formed, condensed, or designed. Particles with mass can emit and absorb energy, such as photons. On the other hand, photons of sufficiently high energy can be transformed into particles with less mass. Analogous relation applied to protoposis, to absolute quantum information. Weizsäcker and Gordon showed that matter is information. They said, mind is neither matter nor energy, rather is protoposis in the shape of meaningful quantum information. And consciousness is quantum information carried by a living brain. That is also protoposis in the space of, in the shape of brain. This is quantum information that experiences itself. Matter, energy, and information are all forms generated by protoposis, or shaped taken by protoposis, are nothing that show itself as something. The implicated order unfolds itself as explicate order through protoposis. So, I invite you to see this. Observation is in the present. Observing the past from all sides, like an ocean of presence with an island of past in the middle. Observation is an opportunity for the past to be understood. In observation, matter, energy, and meaning unfold exactly at the place where the unfolding is most in need. So, as we joke that time in Nashville with Professor Gornitz, all atoms of matter and energy having in their bellies a belly button of proposis, a scar of its birth, a belly button. Like a fingerprint of the unmanifested holiness in the manifested matter, energy, and consciousness. A presence that reveals itself through observation. Intending to translate and transpose that into Portuguese and therapeutic language, I call it troposis, in reference to the term tropism, the movement of the light to the sun, like the sunflowers and other plants. So we made this transposition to troposis. But when we was in our research in therapeutic group in Brazil, we see that troposis is not a translation of protoposis. That we find a new thing. Troposis is protoposis as seen in the reverse way, to say the movement from the manifestation to unmanifestation words. Troposis is in form to explicate, to implicate order, or is the road which goes back to the beginning, or from multiplicity to unity. Protoposis is a proto-consciousness that generates matter, light, and consciousness. But troposis is a post-consciousness open present to holiness and infinite possibilities. Troposis is protoposis in observation. That have value in the therapeutic meaning. When observation happens between two living beings, it makes possible the unfolding of new possibilities. Life came first, then existence. Life is proposis. Existence is matter, energy, and meaning. Alpha, beta, and gamma. This is what therapy is all about. Find out troposis through therapeutic observation brings the client back to who he or she really is. When the client meets all the possibilities of unfolding in a new manifestation through actual protoposis, closer to what he or she really is. Observing troposis in the client-therapist relationship gives the access to the source of the abundance in spring of will, from where the client has unfolded as that human being, the I am experience, which he or her capacities and difficulties. It gives access to the possibility of change on the state of being. Observation helps the client to a new unfolding. So, observation is learning. Troposis is protoposis in observation. Observation with no prejudices and no purpose to curing the client opens the client's life for the best possibility of unfolding according to the highest aspiration and potential and potential of being. Imensa vida, the immense life, is a system of observation. There is some books like this, Immense Life, that I put out in the table in the entrance. It's a book that now is in four languages now. This Immense Vida, this book, is a system of observation where I show the alpha, beta, gamma in sequence of birth within family from the father's standing point, characterizing the modes of operation and needs. The alpha child is the first, the fourth, and the seventh from the father. The beta child is the second, the fifth, and the eighth. And the gamma child is always from the father. In this audience, maybe the most people are first son or third son. It's difficult to find artists. The artist is the beta child, is the 7, 5, and 8. In Mexico, in fact, we work with families about 20 sons, so many people. And we try to understand this model, this research from 25 years. I put here some things about the alpha child. The alpha, you understand each one of us is or alpha or beta gamma from the father. Okay. You are one, Richard. You are the first?
Yes. I'm the fourth.
The fourth, yeah, are alpha gamma.
Yeah, it's like the alpha.
And Alex, tell me that is the fourth. Well, the alpha child, children, do things with the material field. Do what nobody expects. Do things, big and daring projects, great achievements. The alpha, do without caring about the difficulties. They are very hard mind. Do things to be observed. This is the alpha child. The beta child, where I am, is do for the energy. Do things by the creativity. Do things considered impossible. Do artistic things spontaneously. To do things to be felt. This is the difference. The alpha must be seen, the beta must be felt. And the gamma, the 3, 6, and 9, do things full of meaning. This is the question, matter, energy, and meaning. The family is an unfold of this contest. Gamma, do things full of meaning. Technical things. Do things with perfectionism. Do things considered difficult. Do things of great value. Well, it's a little bit, but the book is bigger. And I can send a PDF book. In the end, we'll put my email if you want. So, we understand that the alpha, beta, gamma is the way of unfolding the manifest from the manifest. So the families, the life, the our life in families replies this movement of life. So returning to the Bert Hellinger, the guy, Germany guy who works, the founder of Constellation Systems, he put this orders in the system. He puts important points that all the system is a hierarchy place. So, looking to the client, the position of the first song, the second and the third must be in order. If the second is more, is in the place of the first, or there is some movement here, without the hierarchy's place, there is no order. Other thing that Bert Hellinger points out, in family, all must be included with a proper space to fit in. If someone in family are excluded, someone born to re-include that contest in the family. So it's impossible to exclude something. And other order of Bert Hellinger is there is an equilibrium between the people, between the people of the family system. So orders in which unfolded the best opportunity in life. So according with that order, when the client is being observed and included in that great movement of light, it reveals troposis. The phase of protoposis connects the client back to an unmanifested immensity. That is what liberates the client life from the vicious pattern of the system. What are the best possibilities? Well, today Dr. Crocker will tell about you the eurythmic movement of the best possibilities. But that is that comes about when the person feels included and feels rightful place within the system. According to his position of birth, consider the hierarchy of belonging, troposis is met in observation. Observation does not divide the experience in observer and observed. It has no subject, no object. In observation, the observer is the observed. This is unity, not duality. Observation is not from nor consciousness. Observation is already the holiness observing itself. For that is why Bert Hellinger pointed out that therapist has no proposed and looks to the solution, not to the problem, and the solution is unknown to everybody. What gives the freedom for the client to be what he or she really is, no matter who she or he is. That's the special energy, the factor that allows the troposis actualization. That is turning point in the therapeutic process. With David Bohm, we've learned that no unfolding happens if the best possibility is not coming closer. Troposis is the barrier of that deepest change. Well, I hope you enjoy.
Thank you very much. Do you have questions for the speaker? Comments?
I do have one comment. There, you mentioned the whole thing, connection with consciousness and all that. You might want to get in touch with Shaul Sorek in Ben Gurion University. He actually does research along those kind of lines. I co-authored a paper with him, and originally the way he had got in contact with me was trying to get me to work on something with him with those lines. I didn't do it, but he does exactly that sort of stuff, so you might want to contact him.
Well, what I suggest you is to understand a little bit more about this whole movement of the family and how each one has a special place. And this is important because all of us, we have students,
right.
We have family, we have sons, daughters. And if we go further in this, we can see better the better shape for how to educate and how to make growth each one. Okay?
Any further questions or comments? Okay, we'll back to the speaker again then.